Welcome to today's video. Today we take a look at how to pronounce earnings growth. We will take a look at the definition of earnings growth, and we'll look at some examples of how they are used. First, let's look at the pronunciation of earnings growth. So we have earnings. So focus on the er sound. This er sound is called a schwa sound, schwa plus r sound. The international phonetic symbol for this is this one, er. And it is characterized as an R, it is a so-called R-controlled vowel. So the way to pronounce the er sound in earnings growth, is as follows. So mechanically, what you have to do is you have to raise the back of your tongue so the back tongue touches the inside of the back molars. And if you close your eyes, you can feel the back of your tongue will touch, the sides of your tongue will touch the inside of your back teeth, the insides of your back teeth. So, if you say this, you can feel your tongue touch the inside of your back molars. Now let's take a look at the definition of this word, earnings growth. So earnings growth, it is characterized as the annual rate. It is characterized as the annual rate at which a financial instrument generates growth, and it is expressed as a percentage. Let's look at the word earnings growth in example sentences. Basic math indicates that the winning strategy for investing in common stocks is to possess all of America's publicly held businesses at the lowest cost possible. This will serve for attaining almost all of dividend and earnings growth generated by these businesses. So when we said this will serve for attaining almost all of dividend and earnings growth, what happens to the D and earnings growth? The D is cut off. Check out the video on how to speak fluent English for more details about elision. Let's look at earnings growth and more examples. As you can see, I've indicated the schwa R sound in bold. So you can see earnings used here. There are stocks that have shown rapid earnings growth, 25% or better. So here we have the word rapid. Therefore, you have to join rapid with earnings together. And that results in the sound rapid earnings, rapid earnings. So what we end up saying is actually rapid earnings. And this phenomenon in linguistics, where we join the end of the letter with the beginning of a letter of another word, this is called catenation. Check out the video on how to speak fluent English. Next example, earnings growth is arguably the most important metric of growth for a business because earnings growth represents the health and profitability of a business after all expenses are paid. In other words, earnings growth is practically the most important measurement for growth for a business or a corporation. Why? Because earnings growth, it indicates the health or the sound financial management of and the profitability of a corporation after all expenses are paid. Another example sentence, to support growth in stock prices, strong earnings growth is necessary to keep expensive valuations at a less expensive level. So here we have the word strong precedes earnings. So again, we can use catenation. So we end up saying strong earnings. To support growth in stock prices, strong earnings growth is necessary